Breaking news. Judge signs the release of Igboho's aide after 53 days in DSS custody. Hello, my wonderful people. Some people might be wondering and say, Madam, I thought you released the news saying that Igboho's aide has been given opportunity to be released from DSS custody. My people, na so we see amo. The judge then released the matter when they give the last court injunction. They say they feel freedom. They can't give what we call circumstances or conditions for the bail. The condition not be small condition. No. It just be like say they don't make them bail them before. And guess what? When the judge talk the matter, I know they end there. The judge gets to also sign. Okay. To say you don't free, now one matter. To consign the matter, say, the paperwork, now another thing. They don't free them since, so they don't, according to words of mouth. But they never release them since. They see the DSS custody. And finally, the judge consigned the paper for their release at day 53. Yet, the one they keep what they call Boko Haram and the rest of them, they give them what we call repentant bandits. They give them jobs, businesses. The ones where no one do soldier. They soldier, they DSS, they police everywhere. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up, subscribe if this is your first time. God bless you. After 53 days in the custody of the Department of State Security Services, the 12 aides of the embittered Yoruba Nation agitator, Chief Sunday Adeyemo, popularly known as Sunday Igboho, are set to taste freedom again. Justice Obira of the Federal High Court Abuja on Monday finally signed their release order. The punchline that the presiding judge ignored the persistent argument of the DSS lawyer Idewu Awo and signed the release order of the four contestants detained. They have been there and this is day 53. He said the judge could not sign the release of the order of the other eight detainees because three of the sustenance withdrew before concluding the process of perfecting the bail condition of their clients. The eight detainees have still been in police custody up until now. However, they expressed optimism that the three people to stand surety had pulled out would be replaced and the judge will sign their release order too. The judge also urged the DSS to comply with the court order and release their clients immediately. Recall that DSS has approached a court of appeal sitting in Abuja to revoke the bail earlier granted by the Federal High Court in Abuja to the people held and has asked that they remain in DSS custody. Those who only remain in DSS custody or those only being kept there are people from the south. If you are from the north, even if you have killed people, the government will give you a house. They'll be paying you stipends. They'll put you for the army. You become soldier and the rest. But if you are from the south, southeast, south, or you go suffer put. Yesterday, IGP of police made a deal more. Said I still baby glove that they use for IPOB. Say they want me to tighten the glove. Made them not say that they deal with them. However, the judge has signed the release after DSS has accused Sunday Igboho of stockpiling weapons in order to cause mayhem in the country. The court has categorized the bail granted to the applicant in two categories. Eight of the detainees were admitted to bail with a sum of 5 million naira, two sureties, each resident in Abuja with evidence of 2 years tax payment. The remaining four whose bail the DSS opposed had their bail terms for the sum of 10 million, two sureties, each residing in Abuja, and one of them being a civil servant and a federal government minister or any other agencies with not less than level 12. You know, this is how wickedness rose in Nigeria. It is sad though, because you guys do not understand the level at which people are suffering, and those infringing this suffering on Nigerians are the very reason why this suffering is happening in the first place. They are the wickedness that is ruling currently as we speak. They are the ones causing the nation to go in so much anguish. They are the ones who are aiding and, encouraging most of the evil going on in the country to go on. Yet, nobody owes them to responsibility for the actions they have taken. But they squeeze out the others, well-meaning Nigerians who are going about their business. They squeeze them dry, telling them that you have committed one offense or the other. Now, this is not a yardstick to say that if anyone who have committed a crime or criminal offense will not be dealt with. No, if you commit a criminal offense, you are apprehended, you'll be dealt with the full route of the law. You see, this is not that one of those things. But what are we saying? Why is there not the same treatment for all who have committed offense? Why are some getting off? Why others are being tightened there? Do you see what happened recently? Buhari himself was praising and saying, yes, they are doing well with on the front of insecurity. Do you know what insecurity is compared to those who want out of Nigeria? Say they are doing very well with insecurity. In fact, they are the people are the one coming to surrender themselves. Are they really surrendering or you are cutting deal with them? Yesterday, we produced you a news where UN said Nigerian government exposed, where UN was the one who exposed Buhari's government, that Buhari's government, is sponsoring the activities of Boko Haram in Nigeria. This is United Nations. This is not one person is just speaking on Nigerian government, is just trying to make them look bad. No, the UN exposed with document backing that they discovered Nigerian government has been the one sponsoring the activities of Boko Haram in Nigeria. So how do we explain all this? How do we really relate and explain all these things going on? You see that Nigeria, all you see is not all there is. Can you see that all you see is not all there is? There is a lot of deceit ongoing in Nigeria. But God will help us. Because, the common man is suffering for a crime he does not know. Why the other ones are just sharing money and living life as though, it begins and ends with them. Please don't forget to like us, share, subscribe. Click on the notification button so you can get all our latest news. Remember, you have a voice. You have a voice. It matters. Let it count. Please speak out. Speak out for change. Speak out for transformation. Bye for now.